Hello, this is Lazarus at telecomTech, where telecom and networking technologies are simply explained. Today, we'll be simply explaining how BGP prefers the oldest external path as part of the BGP best path algorithm. Now, as always, I ask you to please subscribe to the channel so you can get updates to new videos, and let me know in the comments about topics that you would like me to address in the future. If you do like this video, please do click that thumbs up button. Now, what this attribute actually states is that if we have multiple paths that are external, BGP will prefer the path that was received first, or in other words, the oldest path. It's important to note that this attribute has meaning only when we are talking about routes learned from multiple eBGP peers. So by definition, this attribute is meaningless for IBGP learned routes. Secondly, we should mention that this is not a BGP attribute in the same sense as other attributes. In other words, the age of a route is not a piece of information that's transmitted as an attribute within a BGP update. It's more of an internal mechanism applied by each BGP router to attempt to break the tie between two candidate routes. So let's take a look at this topology to see how the oldest external route is used as a tiebreaker for our BGP algorithm. Here we have R1, and R1 learns about the 30.30.30.0/24 network from both R2 and R3. Now, this network is an external network to our AS, therefore the oldest entry does indeed break the tie if all previous attributes are equal. But let's go through the BGP attributes in order to see how we get to this particular tiebreaker. Now, here is the BGP table of R1. Let's go through these attributes quickly to see how the oldest route becomes the tiebreaker. The weight here is the same, and so is the local preference. Now, neither route was originated locally, and the AS path length is the same. We also see that the origin code is the same. Now, MED has no bearing here since we're talking about eBGP learned routes. And finally, remember, BGP prefers eBGP routes over IBGP routes, but both of these are eBGP routes, so we don't prefer one over the other. The lowest IGP metric as well has no meaning here because there is no IGP being used between eBGP peers. So the very next attribute is the oldest path. Now, there is no indication in the BGP table which route is actually older. That's information that's maintained internally by the router. In our case here, the path via R3 was learned first. So for this reason, this path is chosen as the best. Now, one may ask, why is the oldest path considered best? Well, the logic behind this rule is that it minimizes what is known as root flapping. Root flapping occurs when new routes are learned, which causes the routing protocol to reconverge, causing the route to flap from one path to another. By accepting the oldest external path, you're essentially preventing a newer path from displacing the older one. This ensures routing stability by ensuring that the current best path remains the best. The idea here is that the current path is likely the more stable one than the path which was just learned. So when a router learns about multiple external paths, if all previous attributes are equal, it will choose the oldest path in order to maintain routing stability and to avoid the need for BGP to have to reconverge if a new path is introduced. But remember, this attribute is only relevant to external paths, that is, paths learned from eBGP peers. I hope you found this video useful, and if you have, please click that thumbs up button. If you'd like me to address other related videos, please feel free to let me know in the comments, and please subscribe to get updates to newly published videos. I'm Lazarus at telecom Tech. I hope this has been helpful for you, and I'd like to thank you for watching.